either in this life or in the next life. ثم قال معرفة دين الإسلام. Also he said, and knowing the religion of Islam, you gotta have knowledge of Allah, knowledge of the Prophet of Allah, and knowledge of the religion of Islam. He said, Islam is general sense, is the worship of Allah in the way in which He prescribed, through the messengers that He sent, as has been mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many ayats, which show that the previous revealed laws were all submission to Allah, in Islam. They all came with Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says concerning Ibrahim in Surah Al-Baqarah verse 128, رَبَّنَا وَاجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ. O our Lord, make us Muslims, submitting, obeying, and worshipping you alone, and from our progeny, those who are Muslims, submitting to you. Sheikh Al-Azimi said that an Islam in its particular sense, after the sending of the Prophet ﷺ, refers to that which Muhammad ﷺ was sent with. So we understand from here, Yahwan, is that, and this is the aqidah of the Muslim, that all the prophets and messengers of Allah, they came with Islam. And when we talk to non-Muslims, we should tell them that. Tell them this Islam that you hear now. All of the prophets, they came with Islam. All of them. All of the messengers of Allah, they called the people to submit their will to the Creator. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to worship not but Him. But Islam in its particular sense, after the sending of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, refers to that which he was sent with. This is because that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with abrogates all of the previous religions, so that whoever follows him is a Muslim, and whoever declines to follow him is not a Muslim. So the followers of the Prophet in the time of their prophets were Muslims. The Jews in the time of Musa were Muslims. And the Christians in the time of Isa, Jesus, were Muslims. But since the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent, and they disbelieved in him, they are not Muslims. Furthermore, this religion of Islam is the only religion acceptable to Allah, and the only one which will benefit a person. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, says, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The only religion acceptable to Allah is Islam, Surah Al-Imran. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Imran, also the first ayah 19, this one is 85, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهِ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And whoever seeks to follow a religion other than Islam, then Allah will not accept that from him, and in the hereafter he will be one of the losers. That this Islam is the Islam with which Allah favored Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his nation. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. This day I have perfected your religion for you and completed my favor upon you, and I'm pleased with Islam as your religion. And this is important for us to understand. And we should practice Islam in a way that it is revealed, as we are commanded. And we should do it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should not fall into the mistakes of some wicked ones who they want to bring about a new version of Islam to please the non-Muslims around them. That's why you hear now, oh, there is a moderate Muslim, there is a mutashaddid Muslim, extremist Muslim, I don't know all of these names. Now you practice Islam in a way that is legislated for us, and alhamdulillah. But avoid changing anything from Islam so that you can fit in the community or fit in the society. And people, they neglect the commands of Allah, they neglect the commands of the Messenger of Allah, they disobey Allah, and then they're like, what are we gonna do, man? We have to fit in the society. That's not gonna help you, Ya Abdullah. Learn Islam and be easy, be kind, be gentle, be merciful, and practice Islam that the Prophet ﷺ left the Sahaba upon. Now, he said we should learn this, we should have knowledge of Allah, of His Prophet, of His Deen, rajin bil adilla, not anyway, with the proofs. He said the proof being that which leads to that which is sought. And the proofs for this matter are both textual and intellectual. As for the proofs from the text, is whatever is affirmed by revelation to Wahi, which is the book and the Sunnah. And as for the intellectual proof, is what is that which is established through observation and consideration. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has faithfully mentioned this type of proof in His book. And there are many ayats where Allah tells us that from His signs are such and such. And in this way, intellectual proofs by Allah the Most High are quoted. As regards knowledge of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through textual proofs, the examples of these are the sayings of Allah, the Most High, Muhammadun Rasulullah. Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah, as in Surah Al-Fath, verse 29. Also in Surah Al-Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in Ayah 144, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. And Muhammad is but a messenger, just like the messengers who passed away before him. Shaykh al-Uthaymeen, he says, the intellectual tools are by examining and considering the clear signs which he came with, the greatest of them being the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which comprehends true and beneficial narrations of events and just rulings which ensure the well-being is achieved. That well-being is achieved. In addition to the miracles which occurred at his hands, and the affairs of the hidden and unseen which he informed of and foretold, and could only be known by means of revelation, and which occurred just as he had said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before we move to the next section, which inshallah ta'ala we're going to leave it for the next class, we just review briefly what we covered today. Alhamdulillah, we start with the statement of this great Imam Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, when he said, "I'lam rahimakallah, annahu yajibu alayna ta'allamu arba'i masail. Now may Allah have mercy upon you. That is incumbent upon us, obligatory upon us, to have knowledge of four matters. Al-Ula, Al-Ilmu, وهو معرفة الله ومعرفة نبيه ومعرفة دين الإسلام بالأدلة. The first of these matters is knowledge. So you have to have knowledge. But knowledge of what? Is it knowledge of medicine? Of math? Physics? Engineering? No. Knowledge, which is knowledge of Allah and awareness of Allah first, and knowledge of His Prophet and knowledge of His Deen. Now you find a person have a lot of knowledge in this dunya, come to technology, come to software, come to subhanAllah, it's amazing, but then they don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't worship Allah. That knowledge is not going to benefit them. Yes, in this dunya they become famous. Oh yeah, he's the one who come up with this idea, who's behind this software, who's that, who's invent this. But they don't know their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that fame and that wealth that they amass in this life is not going to be of no benefit. So this is what is more important for us to know. To have knowledge and awareness of Allah. Likewise, knowledge of this man who was sent as a mercy, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You find people, they have knowledge of so many players and singers and actors and actresses and this and that, but they don't know the Prophet of Rahmah, the Prophet of Mercy, that only through him and that which he came with from Allah, a person will be admitted in paradise. Only those who obey him will enter in paradise. Those who disobey him, they will be destroyed and they will lose themselves. Likewise, knowing Islam, this religion of Allah that guarantees progress and security and prosperity and ease in this life and joy and happiness in the hereafter. So it's incumbent upon us, ya Ikhwan, not to just stay Muslims like that. Some people, they're just Muslim by affiliation because they were born in some Muslim country and that's it. Some others, Allah guide them to the Islam, but they don't make efforts to learn Islam. So we have to make efforts, ya Ikhwan, to try to learn our religion. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who, when they listen to this speech, they follow the best of it. May Allah grant us beneficial knowledge, that is capable of righteous actions. May Allah grant us ikhlas, sincerity in everything we say and everything we do. Barakallahu feekum wa jazakum Allah khaira. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa taslimu al-kafirullah.
Jazakallah khaira.